What to do when your son or daughter does not listen to you? What are you to do when your child cannot listen to you? In some cases, it's not necessarily that your child is not listening to you, but you are just saying to yourself, look, I am where I am today. I'm not as successful as I wanted to be. Or maybe I have struggled to get to where I am now. And I don't want my children to suffer the same way that I've suffered. I don't want my children to go in circles. What do you do when your teenager or your young adult is no longer listening to you? So the other day, a middle-aged man called me and said, Dr. Mutoko, I have a boy who was schooling outside the country. Right now he's back and we are trying to think of which other course they can do and which university they can go to. And I was looking for someone who can give some career advice to my boy, and your name came to mind. So I say, okay, cool, no problem. I'll be very glad to work with your son and help him. I love empowering young people. So we made an appointment. I sat down with the young man. The young man is 20 years old, and he tells me his aspirations, you know, and all that, what has happened in the past and where he's going. And then I start asking him some important questions. And before, and you know, I was just jotting down some notes as we are talking. And then I said, look, I'm not going to tell you which course you should study. Neither am I going to tell you which institution you are supposed to go to. But, you know, I gave him some pointers, talked about what he is trying to achieve in his life. You know, guess what? A few days later, he sends me a message to say, thank you so much for your help. I have now made a decision. He made a decision, not the course that the parents wanted him to study, not some of the suggestions that I have given him. He chose his own because he had been empowered. When your son or daughter does not agree with you, whether in the issues of relationships or in the issues of career or in the issues of life in general, it's important for you to get a mentor for them. Get a mentor for them. Look for somebody who is neutral in your family. Just the other day, another man also called me. He said, look, I need my son to see you. We are disagreeing. I'm not agreeing with my wife. And my wife is not agreeing with my son. You know, there's just turmoil in the home and the temperature is very high. Dr. Mutoko, we need your help. Let me know whether you want me to have a meeting with all the three of you concerning the career of your son, or you want me to meet up with your son, the two of us. All right? It's very important. So never assume that you are right when you're dealing with your children. And one of the major mistakes that we make as parents is that we say to our children, look, you children of today, you are very lazy. You liked fun too much. You know, we were better. We worked very hard. That's one of the worst things you can ever tell your children. Your life is your life. Their life is their life. Nobody is better. They have their life. Even if, okay, fine, you are saying your upbringing was better. So what? So what? How is it going to help me? I'm a teenager right now. There is turmoil. There are no jobs. I'm going to school. Maybe I'm studying what I don't like. And you tell me that during your time, things were better. Okay, so what? The best thing you can do is to sit down with your son, sit down with your daughter, listen to them carefully, understand their concerns. Many of the teenagers and the young adults do not even talk to their parents. They can't ask for advice on relationships. They can't ask for advice on, you know, life in general. They can't ask for advice concerning career because either the parent is absent The parent is there, but is absent. He's busy with their own career, and they forget their children. Or maybe the parent is always prescribing what the child must do. I mean, as a child, yes, your son or your daughter would love to learn a lot from you. But not only you. I think by now, those of us who have teenagers in their homes, you know that teenagers don't just accept everything you tell them. You tell a teenager, do this, they say, why? They ask you why. Why are we doing it? And you must be ready to answer. It shows that they are growing. It's not like they are being disrespectful, but it just shows that they are growing. So if you are not trained to deal with the teenagers, or you don't have the experience of dealing with teenagers and young adults, then look for somebody who knows how to do it. Look for somebody who is passionate about empowering young people. Look for somebody who has years and years of experience in mentoring young people so that they can help you to empower your young one before you lose them for good. Some young people have now gone into drugs. Some young people have gone into dangerous things. Some have gone into, you know, occult because their parents don't listen to them. Please listen to your son. Listen to your daughter. Let them ask you questions. Where possible, answer the questions. If you can't answer some of the questions, refer them to a mentor. Let them go through a mentorship program for 6 months, for 1 year. You can see a huge difference. We don't want to lose any more teenagers. We don't want to lose any more young adults. Let's take care of them. Let's listen to them. Let's ask them pertinent questions that help them. And let's stop telling them how good we are, how better we are, how better our generation is. There is no better generation. We are all important. Thank you so much. Leave a comment.